Mrs. M. Priyadarshini, ME MBA, is doing PhD, is currently working as teaching fellow in the department of IST, Anna University, Chennai. She completed a master's in software engineering from Anna University. She has about 10 years of experience in handling courses for UG and PG. She was serving as technical evangelist for corporate over 4 years in Java Enterprise Technologies, Software Engineering, Databases, WOAD and Design Patterns. She is proficient in handling IT projects as well into concept development for enterprises. She is doing a research in the area of web services security. Her other areas of interest include software engineering, WOAD, databases, enterprise technologies and service-oriented architecture. She holds many journal publications and conference proceedings in her research area.
Welcome to UGC Lecture Series in Computer Science Java Part 20. So in today's session, we are going to see about multicast sockets, demo of multicasting. And then we are going to see how your normal client server program is going to be converted into a chat program. Before we enter into the multicast socket, just we'll have a recap of what we have seen in the networking. So we have seen the basic classes such as INET address, your URL connection. So all these are basic classes that are used in order to do network programming. And then we have seen socket programming using TCP as well as using UDP. So the basic difference between your TCP and your UDP is TCP is a connection oriented protocol and your UDP is a connectionless protocol. So in case of TCP, we have classes called socket and server socket. So socket is the class which is going to establish a connectivity between the client and the server socket. So at the server side, the server socket will be listening to the request, that is the message that is sent by your socket. So from your socket, you are going to send information to the server socket. At the other end, the received information will be again a socket. So the socket at your client and then your socket that is accepted at your server side, both are going to share the streams. So the input stream of your socket at your client side will be connected to the output stream of the server side, and the output stream of your client side socket will be connected to the input stream of your server side socket. So both these streams are interconnected, and this makes a connection oriented data transfer between your client and server. So whenever we establish the connectivity, we check whether particular server is available, and if it is available, we will be sending the data from the client to the server. This is in case of TCP. Whereas in case of UDP, we use classes called datagram packet and datagram socket. So client side, we normally create datagram packets. These datagram packets are going to hold byte array, and this will be sent to the server. At the server side, we will be having a datagram socket, which is going to receive the datagram packets. So at the client side as well as at the server side, we are going to have datagram socket, which is going to send and receive the information. So in case of your user datagram protocol, what we have to do is we have to specify to which particular destination and to which particular port number you have to send the information. So similarly, while we receive the particular datagram packet, from the datagram packet we will get the information about from where you have received that particular datagram packet. So the packets are the data that has been sent from your client to the server. So in both the TCP and UDP that we have seen in the previous session, it is a unicasting. So in unicasting, in the sense there will be only one client and one server involved in this particular client server program. So whereas here we are going to see about multicasting. So this is one particular server is going to send some information to multiple clients. In this case, we need to use a multicast socket. So multicast socket is similar to that of your other socket classes. Whereas here, there are a set of IP addresses which are used in order to create a multicast socket, which is used in order to create a multicast socket on that particular address. So, in a particular multicast address, we can create sockets, and through those sockets, your client and server program connectivity is being established. So, now you can see that public class multicast socket extends your datagram socket. The multicast datagram socket class is useful for sending and receiving IP multicast packets. So, here even in this case of your multicast socket, we are only going to have a datagram packet. This multicast socket is an extension of your datagram socket. So, here in this particular case, we are going to send and receive the IP packets. So, this socket that we are going to construct is capable of sending and receiving your datagram packets. The only thing is, we are going to send to multiple users. A multicast socket is a UDP datagram socket with additional capabilities for joining groups of other multicast hosts on the internet. I have one particular system, one particular IP address which acts as the multicast host. So, from this multicast host, we are going to send information to various clients. So, all these clients who are going to receive the information should be connected to this particular multicast host. So, multicast group is specified by a class D IP address and by standard UDP port number. We have seen in networks, we have various classes that are available in order to name your IP address. And we have, in your previous session, we have seen network class A, B, C and all. So, these classes are used in order to create IP addresses on your system. Whereas here, for particularly for your multicast IP address, we use class D to represent it. Here you can see class D IP addresses are in the range of 224.000 to 239.255.255.255 inclusive. So, these from this 224.0.0.02, this particular address, we will be using that as an multicast address. So, here we can create multicast socket on these addresses. So, whereas this address 22.0.0.0 is reserved and should not be used. So, set of IP addresses, few IP addresses will be reserved for a particular purpose, and so in that cases we should not use those particular reserved addresses. So, when one sends a message to the multicast group, all the subscribing recipients to that host and the port receive the message. The socket need not be a member of the multicast group to send messages to it. I have a particular client which is going to send an information to the multicast IP address where my multicast socket has been created. So, that particular sockets which is going to connect to this particular multicast address is going to receive. So, we are going to form a subgroup of subscribers. All these subscribers who are subscribed to this multicast address will be receiving that particular information, provided all of them are binded in on that particular port number. So, when a socket subscribes to a multicast group or port, it receives a datagram sent by other hosts to the group or port, as do all other members of the group and port. A socket relinquishes membership in a group by leave group method. Whenever I subscribe to a particular multicast IP address, so in that case, I can receive the information that is in form of datagram packets. And whenever a person in that particular group sends some information, it will be sent to all the other persons who have subscribed to that particular group. So, here whenever I want to relinquish my connection from that of the group, then I have to use leave group and then I can come out of the group. Whenever I want to establish, just I can again establish a connectivity and then subscribe to that particular host. You can see the constructors multicast socket int. So, create multicast socket without any parameter creates a multicast socket, whereas multicast socket with an integer which is a port number is used to create a multicast socket and bind it to a specific port. So, whenever a socket is created from the client end, normally whichever port number is free, that will be used for communication. If you don't specify any particular port number in which your socket need to be created, whereas if you specify a port number, then that particular port number will be binded to that particular socket. So, the methods available in your multicast socket: join group, inet address joins a multicast group, leave group, and then your inet address, it leaves a multicast group, send datagram packet and then byte. So this sends a datagram packet to the destination with the time to live other than the default for the socket. So here the send method is used in order to send a datagram packet, and the time to live is nothing but till when that particular data that is transferred should be available on the network. So since it is an unreliable, you cannot say that it is a connectionless, we cannot say that the person at the other end are available, is available or not. Here in case of multicast socket, are available or not. So in that cases, I will have a particular time to live till when that particular datagram packet should be there in order to be sent to that particular receiver. We have a multicast server program. So you know that java.net.star. So this is the package in which your multicast socket is available, and then IO package. So here we have a byte array. So you are constructing a datagram packet and then a multicast socket, and then we are having a boolean. So this is going to be used in order to continuously send your data and receive your data. So here you can see that we have a buffer reader which is going to read the input from the console, and then we are going to construct a new multicast socket. So we are going to receive input from the user, and then you are trying to create a multicast socket. Inet address dot get by name. So we are giving a particular IP address. So here you can see that this is a multicast address. So this comes under the range of class D, that the IP address that we have specified. So now this will give an inet address object that is available for this particular. We already have seen that what is an inet address. It is a class which has information regarding the host name, the domain name, and then the particular port number. All these could be mapped into an object called inet address object. So this is going to specify a particular host. So all the information that are necessary to specify a particular host will be available in the inet address class, and you can have the methods of that inet address class, and then you can get the information regarding that. Here I am having an IP address, and then I am creating an object of inet address. So here inet address object will be created. This object is going to hold this particular multicast address. So now I am printing that particular address. So whenever I print this address, all the information regarding to this particular IP address will be printed, and then I am saying multicast socket dot join group and then address. So you can see that here this address is nothing but the multicast, the address object which represents the multicast address. So now I am saying multicast socket, created a new object of multicast socket. This socket particularly joined with a address. This particular address is a multicast address, and then I say while run. So this is for continuous execution of your data entry. So now I have a byte array. So I am asking the user to enter some message. So now whatever I read from the buffer reader, it's sent to a string, and then I'm converting the particular string to 2 bytes. So now this will be stored in the byte array B1. So now I'm creating a datagram packet. So I'm creating a new datagram packet with a particular data. So this is byte. So this is which is taken from the user's data, and then it is being converted into get bytes, and then I have the length. So after this length, I am giving the address. So you can notice that this address is nothing but the address that is constructed using your multicast address. So it means that this datagram packet is intended to be sent to this particular address, to this particular port number. So and then I am saying multicast socket dot send SGP. So now SGP is nothing but the datagram packet. So this datagram packet, which is having an byte array B1, which is your user's input, and then the length of it, the address, that is your multicast address and a particular port number, for this a particular datagram will be sent. So after I send it, so this, since it is under while loop, this keeps on executing, and if something abnormally happens, then it comes out of it. So if you are abruptly closing the program, then it comes out of it. So or else you can just use an option to check whether some particular string has been entered by the user, you can quit that particular string. And then I call mcs.leaveGroup. So this we have already seen that leaveGroup is used to leave that particular socket. So now we'll have a short break and then we'll continue with the execution of this program, the demo, and then how to create a chat program. So welcome back after the break. Now we'll continue with our multicast server program. Our multicast socket dot leave group method. So it means that this particular socket of your program is going to leave the particular group which is being binded to this address. So in this address, so if any client is connected to this particular address, all the clients will be receiving that particular message that is sent by this server program. So it means that this socket is now sending a datagram packet. And then after sending the datagram packet, it leaves the group and then it's going to come out of the group. Whereas who have been assigned or subscribed to that multicast address will be receiving the datagram packet which is sent by this particular server program. This is our client program. So class multicast client. So here even I have a byte array which is going to be receiving our datagram packet. So here datagram packet and then multicast socket. This is at your client side. So boolean run, the same process for your continuous execution of your program. I have multicast socket 5555. So it means that now I am trying to bind a multicast socket at this particular port number. So here we don't have the concept of socket and server socket. So both the sockets are multicast sockets. So now this multicast socket will be created in this particular port number. So we have seen in the server program that we are going to send a datagram packet to a particular multicast address in this particular port number. So now in that particular port number, I am trying to create a multicast socket. So here again, I am creating an address object by giving the same address. So system.out.println address, I am printing the address. Now I am joining to that particular inet address. So that particular program has joined the group and it has sent the information. Whereas this program is going to join the group and then it's going to receive the information. So I'm joining and then I'm having the byte array, and then you can see here we have a datagram packet length. But here you can notice that this already I have told you, here we don't have any address and the port number. So it means that this is the datagram packet which is going to be received. So in case of receiving, we don't have the receiver's address and the port number. So whenever a packet comes in, we are just receiving it. From that packet which is received, you can gather information from where it has been sent. So I am saying multicast socket dot receive. So then I am constructing a string. So this get data method will get the data that is available in that particular packet. So we know that datagram packet has data, the address to which it has to be sent, on port number. All the information will be available in the object of datagram packet that has been received. From that I am separating the data alone and then I am receiving it and then I am converting that into string. So after I receive the information, since it's while loop, it will be keeping on receiving the information. So even here I can check whether a particular message has been received and then I can quit. So for example, if a server is trying to send the information, at the end of sending all the information, I give a message called exit or end. So at the receiver end, if the message, after receiving all the messages, it receives end or exit, so automatically I can check it and then I can leave the group and come out. So till when I have to be in that particular group, I can decide upon. So here the same thing, I am saying I have to leave the group and then come out of it. So here the same process happens as if it's happening in the server end. So now you can see that here we have created two programs. That is, one is your server program and the other one is client program. So your server program is going to send information, whereas all the clients, so not only one client we are going to have, we are going to have multiple clients. So we can run multiple clients at the same point of time, which could be subscribed to a particular multicast address. So if all this, so all the systems which are connected to that particular multicast address, so we have various sockets, so all these sockets will be binded to that particular multicast address. So in that case, so the programs which has joined that will receive this information. So I can open multiple windows, client windows, I can open one server window. From one server window I can send the information to the multicast address, and whoever being connected to that particular multicast address in that particular port number, that particular port number will receive that information. So you can see here I am compiling the multicast server program. Again I can even compile my multicast client program. So here you can see that Java multicast server, whenever I run this program, you can see that the particular address that has been binded with. So we have given system.out.println address. So the address inet address. So the inet address points to this particular multicast address. So then it is asking for some message to be entered from the server end. So you can see here, this is a client program. This is also connected to the same IP address of that particular multicast socket. So now you can see that whenever I enter the message, so this gets displayed in your client program. So you can see that there are various clients. So we have two client programs, whereas only one single server programs. Your server can keep on sending the messages since we have used while loop. So in this case of multicast socket, so previous versions of your Java doesn't have an option called channel, whereas here in case of newer versions of your Java, we have a package called java.nio.channels. So here we have an interface called multi-channel, a network channel that supports IP multicasting is your multicast channel. So the creation of the channel should specify the protocol family that we are going to use that corresponds to the address type of the multicast groups that channel will join. Here multicast channel is a particular channel through which you can send and receive the informations, whereas there you can see that it follows only UDP. So UDP is used, and then using that particular UDP, that is your datagram packets, you are sending it to multiple clients. So whereas here you can establish a channel. So this interface called multicast channel will help you in order to establish a particular channel, and even you can not only works for one particular protocol, it works for a set of protocols. So all these you can specify the particular type of protocol, and based on that you can establish the channel. So since it is an interface, the classes which are going to implement this interface could be implemented in a fashion that it can be used for various protocols. So next is about chat application enhancement. In this program, in multicast socket program, we have seen that one particular server sending information to many clients. So whenever I include a while loop, so it means that continuously your sockets will be sending the information, as well as at the other end continuously your sockets will be receiving that information. So this is in case of multicasting. So in your previous sessions and all, we have seen that in case of your TCP and in case of your UDP, what we have done is from those are unicasting. So one person sending information to the other person. So you can see the chat application is normally between two users. So between two users, it means that it will be in form of your TCP or it may be in form of your UDP. So your TCP program or your UDP program could be converted into a chat program. So between two particular users. So here two particular users now has to act as a client as well as the server. So one client is going to send some information to the server. So from the server end, then again I have to send the information from the server end to the client end. So now I need to have socket at the client side, which is going to send some information. Similarly, a server side socket which is available also is going to send some information. So, in case of your TCP, how you establish this chat application means, we have two sockets, one is your client side socket, another one is the socket which is accepted at the server side. So, I have already told you that two streams are there, input stream of this is connected to output stream of your server. Similarly, output stream of your server is connected to the input stream of your client program. So, now whenever I send some information from here, automatically that will receive at the other end. Whereas, from that particular socket, if I am sending an information to this particular socket, so then I can use this particular information that has been received. So, now the stream acts as in the middle in order to send and receive the information. So, whereas similarly in case of your UDP, from your client end I am going to send a datagram packet. So, at the server end I am going to receive that particular datagram packet. From the datagram packet I could get the information regarding the client which has sent the datagram packet. So, based on the client and the port number, I can access even the port number from where my message has been sent. So, from there I can again send the datagram packet, provided you have a receive method that is returned in your client program also. So, your client program as well as your server program both should have the send method and your receive method been activated. So, both ends, first I have to send it from my client end to the server end, and from the server end to the client end I have to send, and at this left hand side, that is your client end, I need to have a receive program. So, this is for one message passing between your client and server, and again from your server and client. Whereas, if it has to happen continuously till particular message has been transferred between them, or you can have your program, you can write your program in such a way that you have some other mechanism in order to stop your chat that happens, that is the data transfer or message transfer that happens between your client and server. So, you can see that. So, your send process need to be put inside a do while loop. Similarly, your receive process should also be put inside a do while loop. So, in case of your TCP, I need to have a send process and I need to have a receive process both put together in my do while loop. So, my send process will be sending, at the other end I should have my, at the server end I should have my receive process. So, this should be at my client side and this should be at my server side. Again, if I am going to send some information from the server side, again from here I need to have my server process and then I have to have my receive process. So, here first I should have sent, in the server I should have received, because you know that first initially the message transfer or information transfer will be starting from your client end. So, first you have to start the send process of your client. So, from your client you have to send information, because always before sending the information, before you pass some information, the server should be readily available. So, then only I can send the information. So, in that case my send process happens, again from the server my sending process happens. Send process should be the first process in the client side, and at the receiver end my receiving process. Similarly, next process what I need to do at my client side is my receive process, and in my server side should be my send process. So, either should happen. So, similarly you have to code for your UDP also. In this session we have seen about what is a multicast socket, how it is different from that of your unicasting, and then we have seen a sample program which does multicasting, so from one single server to various clients, and then we have seen how a normal client server program is converted into a chat program. So, by having a continuous send and receiving process. So, from this session we will be able to answer the questions such as what is a multicast socket, how to join and leave the multicast group, and then how to create a chat application using TCP and UDP. Thank you.